Hi friends, this is Lauren Taylor and I'm so excited to be back on the Pretty Pink Posh YouTube channel. Today we're going to be creating a fun Halloween themed card using lots of new products from the latest Pretty Pink Posh release, like the adorable Halloween cupcake stamp set and its coordinating dies, the Spooky Wishes shadow die set, and the new Layered Candy Treats stencil set. I've already done my die cutting and my stamping and die cutting, so let's jump into creating our background. I've cut down a piece of gray cardstock and I'm going to apply it to the center of this grip mat that I have on my glass mat so that way my paper and my stencils won't move as I'm stenciling. And I'm going to grab the A stencil to start with. I'm going to be using Distress Oxides and some brushes to apply my ink. And I'm just going to quickly go through so you can see how each layer has different colors as I'm stenciling and adding some fun through these layered candy treat stencils. So I'm starting with Lost Shadow, and I'm doing this on the white parts of my candy corn, the lollipop sticks of my candies, and then I brought in milled lavender to be some of the wrappers of those candies in that first stencil. I'm bringing in the B stencil, and there's a lot more candies on here, so I'm going to do a few different colors. I have dried marigold, and that's going to be the orange of my candy corns, and I'm going to now bring in some twisted citron, and the twisted citron is going to be the green kind of oval shaped candies. I'll also bring in salvage patina to be the longer candies. There's like three different kind of spots on these candies, so the blue will be the two edges. And then I'll also bring back the milled lavender, and I'm going to use a larger brush to fill in all of those kind of lollipop circle shaped candies. For the C stencil, I'm only going to do some stenciling, and then I'm going to bring it back later to use some stencil paste. So I'm going to bring in Squeeze Lemonade, and I'm going to finish off my candy corns. And then I will also bring in Spun Sugar to color in the rest of those longer shaped candies with the blue on the sides. So I'm going to peel this off and set it aside, but I'm going to finish off the rest of those stencil openings once I'm all done adding in ink. So I'm going to grab my last stencil here with the cute jelly beans and wrappers. And I did notice that I needed a little bit more orange and green on my card. So I'm just going to grab again that dried marigold and color in some of the jelly beans and twisted citron and color in the rest of those jelly beans, and once again Lost Shadow to color in some of the wrapper ends. Those are my blue and pink candies. So now that everything is stenciled in, I'm going to just spray that third stencil in the layered set and clean off any of my distress ink, and I'm going to layer it right back onto my background, and then I'm going to grab some stencil paste. This is Pearl White Stardust Butter from the Crafter's Workshop, and I'm just using a little palette knife, and I'm going to add it where it layers onto an already colored in candy. So my green and purple candies, as well as the swirls on my lollipops. So just being very careful, take your time. I do speed up my videos, otherwise we would be here for an hour. So I am just adding a little bit onto those openings, doing my best not to accidentally get any into another opening on the stencil, but honestly it wouldn't have been too sad if I would have had more shiny spots. I love a good stencil reveal, so let's take a look at how the background has turned out now that we've finished adding in all of the ink and the stencil paste. I love the soft look that this background has, so I'm going to set it aside to dry, and I'm going to pick up my workstation so we can move on to the next step. Now I had already die cut my Spooky Wishes shadow die set, so I have my shadows cut out of some purple cardstock that I thought matched milled lavender pretty well, but I'm going to add in a little bit of ink to the bottom edges of these two shadow die cuts so it has a little bit more of an ombre effect, and it will really blend in with the purple that I have on my background for those little Halloween candies. I die cut the word Spooky Wishes out of some holographic cardstock. It does have a craft backing, so it doesn't look holographic right now, but it is on the other side. I'm using my tweezers to hold it and my glue with a fine point tip to add adhesive to the back side, and then I'm going to layer that onto the shadow die. I think this really shiny sentiment on top of the purple is so pretty. And this holographic paper actually did inspire my color choices. It has a very fun kind of soft rainbow shine to the holographic cardstock. And that's why I went with so many colors on my distress inked and stenciled background. I repeated the same process with the wishes, but I'm going to add the little tittle of the eye by adding a little bit of glue onto the shadow piece rather than the word piece, and then used a jewel picker to drop that little dot above the eye. Now that my sentiment is done, I want to do some coloring of my images. I stamped 4 of the cupcakes. There are 6 total in this stamp set, but in my head, I could only fit 4 when I was kind of determining what I wanted to do for this card. So I've stamped 4 of them and already die cut, and I just attached this to a low tack sticky mat. This particular one is from scrapbook.com, but use what you have in your stash. You just don't want your paper to move while you're coloring, but also not too terribly sticky that you won't be able to take them off when you're done coloring. So I'm going to go through my Ohuhu art markers. I like to use the Honolulu markers, preferably Honolulu B, and I'll just kind of run through the colors that I've chosen for my card today. So for the purples, my darker color was V160 and my lighter color is R250. My coloring is going to be 2 shades today. I just wanted to keep it nice and simple so it's easily able to be reproduced by anyone watching this video, especially if you have these markers. You can just kind of use what you have, but I wanted to share the colors that I thought matched well with the distress inks and the rest of the colors on my card. For orange, I'm using YR090 as the darker shade and YR4 as the lighter shade. So I've added purple to the top of one of my cupcakes, to the Argyle print and my spider web, and I'm adding orange to my cute little jack-o'-lantern, as well as some sprinkles and the Argyle print as well. For green, the darker tone is going to be GY3 and the lighter tone is going to be G050, and I'm going to be using green for a lot of the cupcakes, I guess you could say, because I'm going to be using it to color in 2 of my cupcake liners. So I have this one here with the purple, and then I'm also going to color it in above with my jack-o'-lantern. I also use these 2 colors to color in the stem of the jack-o'-lantern, and I did forget to say that I colored in the jack-o'-lantern's face with a gray, and that was CG050. So once all the green is colored in, so I have those 2 liners and my little spiderweb cupcake, I'm going to go into the yellows. And I used yellow on the stars, the Argyle, and the top of my pumpkin cupcake. And those 2 colors were Y070 and Y050. For the pink, I'm using R190 and RV270 to color in the liner behind my spiderweb cupcake, and then it will also be some sprinkles and just some little touches with this pink color. So like the green, I filled in the dots of that liner. For the blue, I'm bringing in BG68 as the darker and BG4 as the lighter, and for that I'm coloring in more of my details on my cupcakes, like my ghost, my spider, and my bats. Finally, I'm going to bring in some chocolate, so it's E260 as my darker tone, and that's going to be kind of the glaze on this jack-o'-lantern cupcake, as well as the chocolate frosting for my bats, and the lighter color is E110. So that will pretty much summarize all of my coloring that I've done. If you have any questions about Ohuhu art markers or how I'm coloring, you can check out other Pretty Pink Posh videos as well as their Instagram, because I do sometimes post some coloring guides. To add in some final touches to my images, I'm just using a white gel pen to add in some highlights. I don't really have any kind of rhyme or reason to what I'm highlighting. I just put it where I think it would look nice, because I don't really have a light source on this card. So I imagine the light source is from the card receiver looking at the card. I don't have like a sun or anything on the card. So once I get 2 of them done, I peeled them off and put them in a little tray so I don't accidentally smear any of the white gel pen, because I do that more often than I'd like to admit. And then I went ahead and added the gel pen to these final 2 cupcakes, and then I will peel them off this low tack mat just like I did the other ones. So now all of the different elements are done for my card. My background seems to be dry, so I'm going to go ahead and start assembling everything together. I have an A2 card base. This is side folding because I'm going to end up making a card in landscape, and I'm going to use my tape runner to attach my stenciled background to the center of the card. I did cut this to be slightly smaller than A2, it's like a quarter of an inch smaller. So it actually, I believe, an eighth of an inch smaller. Yes, it's a very tiny white border around this background. So instead of 4 1/4 by 5 1/2, it was 4 1/8 by 5 3/8. But do what you like when you're adding your background to a card. I like a little bit of a thin white border. In my head, I was originally thinking I was going to do this card in portrait, but I wanted more of my background to show, so I kind of settled on this rough layout in landscape. So I was going to use my mint tape to help keep all of my different pieces of this card in place, but I decided to not worry about it. We're gonna wing it. We're gonna have some fun placing all of these images on. I added some foam adhesive behind my spooky wishes sentiment. Now the Y is going to tuck in behind the W and the I just because of the amount of space that I had on this A2 card. So I didn't add any foam adhesive behind those letters and instead added some wet glue. And then I'm going to tuck the end of my Y on top of the end of my H, little swirly part of the letter, the little flourish. And that way they just kind of overlap each other and fit kind of nicely together like that. I really like how this sentiment looks on my card background. I needed a little bit more stability behind the end of my Y, so I'm just going to throw in another little small piece of foam adhesive. Now I can place my cupcakes on. I am going to take a little minute here to figure out what color order I like the cupcakes. I was trying not to do, you know, the two greens next to each other, but then the two chocolates next to each other was like too much brown on the side. So I play around until I'm happy with kind of the order. And I do have my two green liner cupcakes together, but that's okay. I'm going to add foam adhesive behind all four of these cupcakes. So I'm going to start with my two cupcakes on the end. So I did the right side, and now I'm going to do the left side. And then that way I can add the foam adhesive behind one of my centered and use the other one as a guide to make sure it's going to be all evenly spaced out. And then I put in that last cupcake on. Again, everything on this card is adhered with foam adhesive. For some final touches, I'm going to grab one of the new clay confetti mixes. This is the Hocus Pocus mix, and I really loved the green bats in this collection, these little clay green bats, and I thought they would match really well with the greens on this card. So I'm going to use a jewel picker and just pick up a bunch of these bats and place them around my sentiment. Once I'm happy with how many I have and kind of the placement, I'm going to go ahead and put those back into my little baggie for storage. I do like to trim the name of the confetti mix and put it inside my bag so that way I remember what the name of each little embellishment pack is. And now I'm just using my jewel picker and some liquid adhesive to glue down all of my green little bats. Here is a final look at how my Spooky Wishes Halloween Cupcakes card turned out. I hope you are inspired by today's project and that you are just absolutely loving this brand new release from Pretty Pink Posh. You can find everything that I use from Pretty Pink Posh down below in the description, and I hope you have a wonderful day. Bye!